Begin by allowing your body to get comfortable. Find a position that feels good for you right now. And settle into that posture. Maybe you're sitting on a chair or on a cushion. Maybe you're lying down. Whatever feels comfortable for you, shift into that posture and get acquainted with it. Notice what it feels like and enjoy the comfort in your body that you find. Perhaps there's the pleasure of being supported by the ground, wherever your body is meeting it. Perhaps you feel relief in your body at being supported. Or the restfulness of being still. Whatever comfort you find in your body, even a little bit of it, take the time to really enjoy it. And allow your body to relax. Notice if there's tension that's present anywhere in your body, anywhere that your muscles are holding tight. And gently invite those muscles to relax, to loosen, to let go. Easing that tension, releasing that tightness, relax your body. And again, as you feel that relaxation entering your body, allow yourself to really enjoy it, to savor that release. This simple pleasure of relaxing. Really enjoy that. And if you'd like, if it feels good for you, you can invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. Just a simple smile. Allowing your body to incline your mind towards happiness. Feel that smile, and if any joy does arise from it, really take that in. These three qualities in the body: comfort, relaxation, and smiling. It's as if they're our home base. We establish ourselves there. And should we wander away, should we lose those qualities, we can simply return, reestablishing comfort, reestablishing relaxation, reestablishing smiling, as many times as we need to. We allow our bodies to become accustomed to these qualities, to become familiar with them. So that even though we're intentionally creating these qualities, they begin to feel more and more natural. We familiarize ourselves with them. So without losing these qualities, we begin to involve the mind. Using our intellect, our thinking, to also steer towards happiness. Towards love. Take some time to reflect on aspects of your life that you're grateful for, whatever that may be for you. Maybe it's something simple and ordinary, like having food to eat or a place to sleep. Maybe you're grateful for your friends or your family, for your job. Maybe you're grateful for something specific to you or your day, something unusual. doesn't matter so much what it is that you're grateful for. Simply consider it and attune to it. You can do this by, for example, saying a sentence in your mind. I feel grateful that I had food to eat today. Or I feel grateful for my friend's company. Whatever it is for you, tell yourself about it. Be sure that you can hear these phrases in your mind. You can reflect on the same thing or many different things. Simply cultivate gratitude. To whatever extent you feel this gratitude in your body, that you feel grateful, and notice that and really enjoy it. As you reflect on gratitude with your mind, these feelings may or may not arise, but if they do, savor them, soak them up, be delighted by them. Continue to cultivate gratitude for another moment. Good. Now, bring to mind someone that's relatively easy for you to feel love for. An easy to love person or animal. Perhaps this is a friend or family member. Perhaps a pet or a small child. Or even someone imaginary. A character in a movie that you like, or simply imagining a puppy or a kitten, baby fox or panda bear, an animal that you connect to. In any case, choose someone that's relatively easy for you to love. And bring that person to mind. You might, for example, visualize them. Seeing them in your mind's eye. And imagining them being happy. You could recall a time that you spent together where both of you were happy. Or you could imagine it. Creating such a scenario in your mind. In any case, use visual imagination to connect to a sense of them being happy and wishing that for them, wanting them to be happy. Cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal. If you find that visualizing them being happy is working for you, if you connect to that sense of love, feel free to keep going with that. Or if you'd like, you can try cultivating love through your mental talk, saying phrases that wish this person well, wanting them to be happy. It could be a phrase like, "I love you so much," or "I really care about you," or "I hope you're happy right now." Any verbal phrase or mental talk will do. So long as it's cultivated, connected to a sense of love and care, wanting them to be happy. Feel free to be creative or playful. It doesn't matter so much how you cultivate love, so long as you do. And again, to whatever extent you notice these feelings of love in your body, that you feel it emotionally, resonate with that. Connect to it as deeply as you can. There are three basic doorways towards this love. We can use visual images in our mind. We can use mental talk. And we can use direct access to feelings in our emotional body. Each of these doorways to love is valid. Typically, one will be easier for us than another. And it's important that we come to know ourselves in that way, that we learn over time what works for us to cultivate this love, and to do that more and more. This is a kind of self-knowledge that we grow in over time, knowing what works for us and what doesn't. And of course, you can combine these doors as well, using any combination that you like. Again, feel free to be creative or playful. Simply cultivate love. If you'd like, you can stay with the same person, your easy to love person or animal. Or you can move on to someone else, wishing someone else well. You can stay with one person for a very long time or move through many different people. You get to decide how to practice and who to cultivate love for. However you decide to practice, allow yourself to become more and more familiar with this love, with the art of cultivating it, and with the satisfaction that you find in it. Let yourself be attuned to what works for you. And take responsibility for that. You get to decide how to practice, knowing what works for you, knowing what you enjoy, what feels interesting and alive for you. Do that. Simply cultivate love. whatever happiness or love you find as you cultivate this process. Really savor it. Delight in this love. Very good. Now, take a moment to connect to a way that this love might manifest in the world. Consider if there's an action that you might take that would demonstrate this love as kindness in the world. And if you feel called, set the intention to take that action in the near future. As you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.